Okay, there they are, all 25 coons, tanned and stretched out, ready to be turned into a nice quilt. There they are. Now, some of these coons are different. You notice how that one right there is a bit lighter than the rest. So what I'm gonna take those light ones, like that one right there. See the light ones? That one right there, that one. Take all the light ones and I'm gonna put them in the center of the quilt. As you can see, there's a lot of dark ones, really, really dark coons. Those are the ones I'm gonna use for the outer edge. Yeah, there they are. Hello everyone. I'm here about to get my raccoons ready to make the quilt. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna slice them right down the middle and then open them up and then square them out into nice, good pieces of material that I could just use to put the quilt all together. Let's get started. Okay, I'm gonna start by turning this guy inside out. Now I gotta say, these raccoons definitely have got some tough, tough skin. We have a sharpening stone here because as you go cutting into the hide, you slightly cut into the hairs and the hairs dull out your blade. Now I'm gonna try and use as much of the raccoon as possible. So what I'm gonna end up doing is I'm gonna sew this right there, then chop the sleeves right off. And that should give a nice pattern over here. And then just cut the head off, trim down the sides, and then trim down the bottom. What I'm trying to do is just cut through the skin, really not try to cut through the hair. Now what I have to do is, over here, I just have to square it out on the sides. There is the one piece out of 25. So I've got some work to do. and cut these sleeves right off. But I'm gonna make sure to leave a good amount of room where I could just sew it all closed. Now, any piece that I cut off, I'm not planning on throwing it away. I'm planning on just saving it, putting it to the side for future projects. Because for an example, if you turn this sleeve inside out, you go mainly slide the sleeve into anything. And you know, just have it as a decoration piece. So I just keep that there to the side, and there it is. That is one of them. Gonna lose a couple hairs, of course. I just go down the edges, collecting any loose hairs, and just putting them right in the garbage right here. And there is one piece. I'm going to continue with the next pieces. Oh, that's beautiful. Okay. Let's move on to the next. Now all it is basically the same process. You know, turn it inside out, slice it down the middle, square off wherever needed. I usually like doing my incision right here in the middle of the two top legs, top feet. That way I can, you know, judge where the middle is at. And just go all the way down. Let's cut the head off. Now what I'm trying to do is just eye it the best way possible. Because regardless, when I sew it together, I'm going to need a good amount of hide between the sewings. That way, when you pull on it, you know, it really has something to hold on to. Instead of just ripping right apart. Okay, you see here, this slightly comes out, so I'm just gonna trim this off right here. And there's that one. I just have to cut the sleeves off. Any little hole that I find, I'm just gonna sew it shut and, you know, just make believe it was never there. But yeah, there it is. I love this thing. Okay, so far I've gotten 10 raccoons chopped up. This is definitely gonna take some time, but it's working out. Definitely working out. This is how they've been coming out. After I'm done squaring them all off, then I'm gonna take them outside and separate them all, and then see, you know, coordinate them to the right colors, you know. Like I said before, I wanna put the lighter raccoons in the center of the quilt, and then the real dark ones I wanna put in the outer part of the quilt. But yeah. They're definitely coming out real nice. And then as you can see, some are way bigger than the other. But I'll fix that when I start piecing them together. Get back to chopping them up. Turn this guy inside out. All that stuff is great. Real fact number 1354. You are always looking at your nose. Your brain just chooses to ignore it.
Look at that.
Okay. I've got all 25 coon caught up. There's one. There's two. Three. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, and 25. There they are. Oh man. And if I use all 25 of these, it's gonna be a pretty heavy quilt. So it should definitely keep me warm in the winter. Alright, now I have to go and put them on the floor and you know, coordinate them the best way I can. I'm gonna put the lighter coon in the center of the quilt and the darker coon in the outer part of the quilt. See how it goes.
Okay, and there's the quilt.
I tried to take the lightest coons and put them right in the center and try and keep the darker coons right there in the outer edges. Not bad. Now, I just have to start stitching, which is gonna be a lot of time. But, one stitch at a time, I guess. All right. Time to start sewing.